Amen. 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 Yeah. Amen.
I will bless the Lord.
Yeah.
I will bless the Lord.
Yes, sir.
At all times. And His praises shall continue be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord.
Yeah.
The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me.
Yeah.
Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. He is great. He is holy. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt His name together. All taste and see that the Lord is good. Has He been good to you? Has He really been good to you?
Thank you. Breathed into man's nostril the breath of life, and we, man, became a living soul.
Yeah.
He is the one that divided the light from the night. The light he called day and the night he called, and the darkness he called night. He is the creator of heaven and earth. He is worthy to be worshipped. There's none other that can stand beside him. No one is above him. He is worthy to be worshipped. Not only is he worthy to be worshipped, but it is God's will that we worship him.
Yes.
You know, God prepares all of us for worship. First thing he does is he wakes us up every morning.
All right.
He touches us with his finger of love. God gets us up to worship. And when we become conscious of God waking us up, we ought to tell the Lord, thank you. Not when our eyes open, but when we become conscious. I say that because there are a lot of people whose eyes are open, but they aren't conscious of who God is. Lord, have mercy.
Yeah.
He's worthy, it's his will, and his word teaches us to worship him. Forsake not the assembling of yourselves together as the manners of some. It is a blessing to be in worship among my brothers and sisters. It is so delightful to be in the presence of God and in the presence of God's people.
Yeah.
We must understand that this is God's doing. And it is marvelous in our sight because we are conscious of God's being, conscious of his worthiness, conscious of his will, and conscious of his word.
Yeah.
And so when we look at our text, we see that the prophet Isaiah is in worship.
Well,
he's worshiping God and he has a vision. God gives him this vision of the place where God is, which is heaven.
Yeah.
He sees the Lord sitting on his throne, high and lifted up.
Come on, preacher.
This is the vision that the prophet sees. He says, I saw the Lord.
Yeah.
Pray with me. I'm just going to break down the
scripture. Come on, preacher. Preach it.
We know the scripture needs no explanation. And we may can interpret the scripture. But the scripture speaks for itself.
Yeah.
And so the prophet said, I saw the Lord.
Yeah.
That's personal. There are some experiences that the Lord will show only you.
Yeah.
I know there are many here who can testify that there have been some experiences in our lives that it was only God who got us out of.
That's right.
And nobody but the Lord did this and that. And they are personal experiences. The prophet said, I saw the Lord. And your personal commitment, conviction to God is what the Lord has done for you. Can you say you saw the Lord? You adhered to the will of God. You surrendered to the Lord. He said, I saw the Lord. Is your relationship with God personal?
Well,
yes, Lord.
Yes,
he said,
yeah.
I saw, this is what I saw. It's personal.
Yes.
He said, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne.
Yes.
He saw first the Lord's position. The Lord was sitting on a throne, high and lifted up.
Yeah.
It's the position of the Lord is the position of authority.
Yeah.
God has the final say in everything.
That's right.
He's high and he's lifted up. He has authority. He has authority to say who lives and who dies.
Yeah.
He has the authority to say who can even be tempted by Satan or not. He has the authority to give you strength. He has all authority. There's no limits on God. And so because there is no limits on God and because God has all authority, why not pray to him? Why not ask him what you will?
All right.
Because he can give you everything. He can give you your heart's desire. Ask the Lord what you will. If you want more love, ask the Lord for more love. If you want more peace, ask the Lord for more peace.
Yeah.
He can give it to you. He can give you whatever you need. Ask the Lord. He saw the Lord position. But he saw the Lord high. We'll stop right there. He saw how. How do you see the Lord?
Well,
how do you see the Lord? He saw the Lord high. And if you see the Lord, my brothers and sisters, you have to see him high. Higher than any and everything.
Yes.
Higher than that situation.
Yeah.
Higher than that illness. Higher than that job. Higher than that house or car. Higher than that brother. Higher than that loved one. You have to see the Lord higher than anything.
Yeah.
And if you're going to see, if you see the Lord higher than anything, the only way to see him higher than anything, you have to look up.
That's right.
Look up to the Lord. That's the only way to see him. You can't see the Lord talking negative. You can't see the Lord talking down. You have to see the Lord looking up. I guess that's why the psalmist say, I will look unto the hills. He's going to look up.
Yeah.
Which cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord who has made the heavens and the earth. Look up to him. He saw the position of the Lord. And he saw the priest. He saw the Lord lift. It was the priest.
Yeah.
Whose responsibility was to handle the Ark of the Covenant, the things of God.
Yeah.
The priest touched the things that were of God. But as we can say today, because of our high priest, the veil has been torn.
Yeah.
And so now we, the people of God, can lift him up. Well, do you know how we can lift God up?
Well,
when we live right, we're lifting him up.
Yeah.
When we spread his word, we're lifting him up. When we edify his people, we're lifting him up. I need somebody to help me lift him up. We can lift him higher and higher. The more we talk about him, the more we live right, we can lift him up. On our jobs, we can lift him. On our streets, we can lift him.
Yes, sir.
How we lift him up is to tell of his goodness.
Yes, sir.
Do you have a testimony that can lift God up? Well, I'm sure you do because I have one.
Well,
my testimony is similar to yours. I once was lost. But now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. I didn't know which way to go. But then I heard the voice of Jesus telling me to still fight on. He promised never to leave me. Never to leave me alone.
All right.
I'm never alone because he's omnipresent.
Yes, he is.
Yeah.
He's everywhere at the same time.
Yes, he is.
And so I told you that the prophet Isaiah saw the position of God.
Yeah.
I told you that he saw it was personal. And I told you that he saw the position of God and that it was personal. And he saw the priests and the people of God.
Yeah.
But now tell me, preacher, is there one more thing you can tell me that the prophets saw?
Well,
I know the scripture is full of God's word.
Yes.
And the vision has a lot of message there. But is there one more thing you can tell me, brother preacher?
Well,
what the prophet saw.
Yeah.
He saw the praises of God. The angels in glory were crying one to another, holy, holy, holy.
Yeah.
And the other angels responded back by the only thing they could respond back with, holy,
yeah,
holy. He saw the glory of God. He saw the grandeur of God. And he saw the greatness of God. They were praising God because he was holy.
Yeah.
And so when we look at the vision that the prophet had, we see that it's personal.
Yeah.
We see the position of God. And we see the priest and the people of God. But then we see the praises of God. We see the seraphims crying, holy, holy,
holy,
holy, Lord God of hosts. Now, the God of hosts simply means he is the leader of all armies,
yeah, yeah.
Which means he's victorious in all battles,
yeah,
in all warfare.
That's right, that's right.
He is victorious. He's the Lord of hosts. I can see the angels sing, holy, 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 Lord God of hosts. We can join in with them right now.
Well,
and we can cry unto the Lord, holy, holy,
yeah,
Lord God of hosts. Mercies and love and mercy. He is full of. But don't you know, when we get there, we will have another song to sing.
Well,
we'll have a praise that the angel can't sing.
Yeah.
We will praise him by singing, I've been redeemed.
Yes, sir.
Because of what Jesus did.
Yeah.
He came down through 42 generations.
Yeah.
To save you and I. He bled and died on an old rugged cross.
Yes.
For you and I. He went down into the grave for you and I. But early Saturday morning,
early,
he got up with all power,
yeah,
in his hand. We're in worship now. We can sing a song that the angels can't sing.
Yeah.
I've been redeemed. I've been washed by the blood of the Lamb.
Yeah.
Will you ask, is there anybody here who know that you've been redeemed?
Yeah.
Do you know you've been washed by the blood of the Lamb?
Yeah.
If anybody asks you who I am, tell them I am redeemed.
Yeah.
Have you been redeemed? If you've been redeemed, stand on your feet. Tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you.
While in worship, it's a blessing to be in worship. In worship, you can see the position of God.
can see the power of God. In worship, you can see the praises of God. Let's glorify His name. The Lord.